We're doing crop load thinning in our pecan orchard today. And we've already determined that we are at the right stage. They're in the water stage and they're expanded out about 60% on our Pawnee cultivars. This is a technique that we use on improved varieties because they're larger. In a native orchard or small varieties, there may not be enough mass in the pecans to actually thin them off of the trees. But we look at our crop load to determine if we need to thin each individual tree. And so how we do that is we look up in the middle portion of the canopy and we want to see about 50% of the terminal branches with a cluster. And a terminal branch is just one of these shoots on the end. You can see this one has, there's one, there's two, three, four, five, there's six terminal shoots. And of those six, five of them have clusters. Now, it doesn't matter if there's one nut or if there's seven. We still count, if it has one nut, it's considered a cluster. So we would want to thin until we had 50% of our terminal branches to have a cluster. Now, it seems kind of strange to knock off pecans because we're trying to grow a crop. But it actually is going to benefit the tree tremendously if we can reduce the crop when they're completely loaded. If we let this tree go into the winter, or even if we tried to ripen the entire crop, our quality would be poor. If you think about each one of these nuts needs about 8 to 10 of these leaves, and this is a pecan leaf and these are leaflets, so it needs 8 to 10 leaves to fill one pecan. So if we left all of these pecans on this Pawnee tree, there may not be enough carbohydrates produced from photosynthesis to fill these pecans properly. So we would end up with small pecans or very wafer-like pecans. So the quality wouldn't be like we want it to be. We want completely filled out pecans. So if we reduce the number of pecans on the tree, then they're going to be able to be filled much easier. Also, if we left all these pecans on the tree is going to be stressed. The same time it is trying to fill these pecans for harvest this season, the buds on these tree are also trying to develop fruit buds for next season. So if we have a big crop this year, all the energy is going to go into the crop and none into the buds for the following season. We see this a lot on our native crops. We'll have a huge crop one season and then nothing the next year. And so it's called alternate bearing. With crop load thinning, we can kind of keep our bearing at the same rate, the same stage, same level each year. So we have a good, nice, high quality product each season, not missing years, not on and off. And it also stresses this tree. So when it goes into the winter time, if it is fully loaded, like this past fall, we had a lot of really heavily cropped trees. And then we had a late October freeze right at Halloween. And a lot of those trees suffered a lot of injury because they were stressed. And so if we do our crop load management and reduce the number of nuts on the tree, the tree is going to be able to store some carbohydrates into the root system and into the wood, and it's going to be a lot healthier going into the winter season. We've had trees that completely loaded, then have a really hard cold winter, and they just won't come out, don't bud out in the following spring. So they lose wood even back several years old. And so it's a very important technique, a management tool that our pecan growers need to be thinking about if they have a crop that's overloaded. Another benefit of crop load management is the limbs, when they're fully loaded, are very heavy. So if we have a thunderstorm or straight line winds, we end up with a lot of limb breakage. And so after thinning, the trees are much more capable of going through thunderstorms without any damage.
All right, first thing we gotta do is you gotta size your shaker to your tractor. You don't want to get too big a shaker for your tractor, and the shaker's got to match your trees. We have small trees here, so the shaker's got to match your tree size. This is the 42-inch shaker, that meaning that these pads will open 40. It will open 42 inches without the pads. So in all actuality, it will open in probably about 36 inches. The tractor here, you have a shield on it. If you're shaking big trees, there's a wood, big wood that can come out of that and land on the drivers. But the wood here is not going to be too big, so you need a covering on your tractor to protect your tractor from the sap and other things. So the shaker pads are the most important things to this shaker. These are donut pads, which they squish together. The pads shake together, you center this into the tree and squeeze it together as tight as you can. Grease is the main thing that keeps the friction from ripping off the bark. So we want to lift up this pad and grease that up. More grease the better. Grease that side of the pad, both sides, so you get slippage. If you don't, you'll injure your tree.
Doing our crop load management, we want to have a spotter on the ground that's assisting the person on the shaker. And that spotter is going to look up in the mid portion of the tree. If you look at the very bottom, it doesn't shake as much, so you don't lose as much of those nuts during the shake. And if you look up really high in the tree, it shakes very vigorously, so you'll lose a lot more at the top than versus the bottom. The spotter looks at the middle section of that tree, so they can kind of identify an area, watch it to see when it gets to that critical 50%, and then they can tell the shaker to stop. On crop load management, neither the person on the tractor or the spotter should ever look at the ground to determine how much to shake the tree. Once they see the pecans on the ground, everyone is automatically going to stop. And so you need to keep your eyes up in the mid portion of the canopy to determine if it's time to quit shaking or to continue shaking. There's a lot of pecans on the ground, and those are mainly filled with water, so they'll dry up, and at harvest time they'll just be blown out with the other trash and light pecans. I'm going to demonstrate how to determine what stage your pecans are at, and I've got them from the earliest ripening, which would be Peruke, to Kansa, Pawnee, and Merrimack. And we're going to cut each one of these nuts open to look at the inside at the kernel development. Now, an important part of cutting the pecan at the right place to see the right view, on the stem end, there's a little oval. And you want to cut on the short side of that oval. So not longwise, but shortwise, right across the oval. And so I'm going to cut this nut. Actually, I'm not going to use a knife on this one because the shell has started to harden. And so if I try to use a knife, I may slip and cut myself. So I'm going to cut through that oval, and I'm going to slice down through there. And you may have noticed there was some water poured out of that. And so this is Peruke. They're one of our earliest ripening cultivars. And it is 100% expanded with shell hardening. And you can start to see they develop from the bloom end down towards the stem. And so this one is completely the ovule, the kernel part is it's completely down to this end, so it's completely expanded. It's still in the water stage, so any bit of liquid that's going to this tree is still helping that to expand as much as it can. Once this changes to the gel stage, and then it starts going into the dough stage, that's when we have some signals for other management events. So once the shell hardens, we don't really worry about scab, pecan scab, that much. It really is more of a cosmetic issue, so we don't have to worry about pecan scab on our Peruke at this stage. Now if we look at Kansa, they're the next ones that would ripen. We're going to cut across that oval, and you can see it's got lots of liquid in there, but it is 100% expanded as well. And the shell hasn't started to harden just yet, But this, you can see the inside, this is going to be the kernel. It's filled with liquid endosperm. That's what the water is. And once that liquid endosperm starts to make cell walls, you'll start to have to move into the dough stage. And that's your kernel when it's making the kernel. Now on the Pawnee, this is one we're going to look at. We'll cut it across the oval. And it should be a little bit further behind the Kansa. So when I open it up, it's, you can see there's liquid. And you can see the kernel has developed about probably, oh, maybe 60% expansion. So we want to do our crop load management when these pecans are 25 to 100% expanded. And so we are right on time with this Pawnee. You can see it's about to 60%. You can see that little bit in there, that's gonna be the kernel. So it'll go ahead and expand all the way down to the stem end. And then after it goes into the dough stage, that's when we really need to crank the water up to fill it completely, and also to monitor for our weevil control, because once they go into the dough stage, they're going to be susceptible to weevil laying eggs inside the nuts. Now this is a Merrimack, and it's full of liquid endosperm or water. And this one, the Merrimack's a little bit later ripening. It's kind of what we consider a mid-season. And it's about maybe 25, 30% kernel expansion. So we could go ahead and thin our other varieties if we need to sooner and let these get a little bit heavier, a little more water inside these nuts, and that way we will be able to shake them off the tree a little bit easier. But you can tell which one is going to ripen sooner and on down the line. Now, if you cut it the long ways across the oval, you'll end up getting something like this, and it doesn't show the ovule. It just shows our packing material on the inside, so we can't really tell what the inside looks like. If you, later in the season, we may be doing cuts across the pecan to look at how well the kernel's filled. But right now we want to do that, this cut to see how far that kernel is expanded. For more information on crop load management, we have a fact sheet titled Crop Load Management, and you can find those on factsheets.okstate.edu, or you can go to the pecan management webpage, okpecans.okstate.edu.